Welcome to Nuke's channel, dear viewer. In this video, I will try to explain some of the features of the river tool in the recently released Unreal Editor Fortnite. To find the river tool, open the content drawer and type river in the search bar. When you click and drag the river tool over the viewport, it will be represented as a spline with three control points. Dropping the tool on the viewport will automatically create a river alongside the spline curve. In gameplay, you can see the default look of the river tool. As you approach the river, you can hear the sound of the water stream. The river also has visual effects that represent the stream flow. You can interact with this water body like the ones in Fortnite Battle Royale maps. Impacting bullets create decals on the water's surface. When a hand grenade is thrown into the river, it will float and move with the flow. You can also swim in this river, but as in the Battle Royale map, you can't dive underwater, unfortunately. I also tried if torches have interactions with the water, but they don't interact with each other. When you select the river tool, you can also select a control point and make some changes to the specific section of the river. When you select a point, a setting called water appears in the details tab. You can change the depth of different sections of the river by selecting the corresponding point and changing its depth value. In the game, I changed the depth value of the middle point to around 20 units. As you can see in the gameplay, the river is more shallow at this specific point. Once I move to the deeper areas on either side, I can swim as normal. I changed the depth value at this point to around 50 units and added a dirt bike for testing vehicle interactions with the river tool. I think 50 units represent 50 centimeters in real world scale for UEFN. As you can see in the gameplay, I can ride the bike as normal at this depth, but when I go to deeper sections slowly, I lose the bike and am forced into swimming animation. I changed the river depth to 100 centimeters for all three points, and I can drive through the entire length of the river. It is also possible to walk across the river at this depth value. For testing river width value, I changed it for one of the endpoints to around 9,000 units, which means 90 meters on a real-world scale. It seems that width values don't affect the depth profile of the river bottom. As you can see in gameplay, vehicles can drive over the river surface if they have a high enough speed. But if vehicle speed is relatively slow, they will drown. The river's velocity value affects the visual and sound effects of the river in the game. When you change the velocity value, you can see the flow speed of the river change in real time. The faster the flow speed, the more turbulent and choppy the water appears. Additionally, changing the velocity value also changes the sound effects of the river. You can hear the faster flow sound in the gameplay, which adds to the immersive experience of navigating through a river. The speed of the river affects how fast your character can swim. If the river is flowing too fast, your character won't be able to swim against it. If your character is stationary in the water, the current will drag them even uphill. I thought that changing the audio intensity value would make the river sound louder or softer. However, after testing it out in the game, I didn't notice any difference in the volume of the sound. it's possible that the audio intensity value affects other aspects of the sound effects instead. Even though the landscape is just a surface mesh, when I changed the depth settings in the river tool, it created very deep water sections. As you can see in the gameplay, I set the depth value to 100 meters and it created that river without any glitches. You can change the steepness of the river banks by adjusting the channel edge offset value under the curve settings in the Details tab. This seems to affect the entire river even if you do select a control point. The curve ramp width value under the same settings seems to have a very similar effect. However, I think changing the curve ramp width gives more realistic results. The falloff settings under the water height map settings control the height of the river banks relative to the river surface and landscape. When the river surface is higher than the surrounding landscape, this value creates a high ground along the river banks. When the river surface is lower than the surrounding landscape, it creates a low ground around the river banks. The edge offset value controls the width of the region, and falloff width value controls the width of the blend region between the river banks and the surrounding landscape. Z offset value allows you to change the river bank's height relative to river surface. The curl noise settings under the effects settings make the river banks more jagged and uneven. You can set values for two different noise patterns and their tiling amount and blend two of these to get your desired effect. Using terracing settings under the effects settings, you can create terraces inside the river. To enable the terrace effect, using a value other than zero seems to be enough for terrace alpha, and its value seems not to improve the effect further. You can change the elevation of a specific part of the river by selecting one of the control points. In the game, I raised the endpoint of the river around 8 meters and now the river is flowing uphill. As you can see, speedboats can cruise through rivers, even if they are flowing uphill in Fortnite. Thanks for watching and please don't forget to like and subscribe. Have a nice day.